If you guys are looking for super cheap, fast, and reliable Madden 21 coins, look no further than my sponsor, MuttReserve.com. Coins are currently discounted, guys. They got 24/7 support. They're super awesome to work with. Head on over, use code Poodle for an additional 15% off your order. What's going on, everybody? It's Poodle back with another Madden Ultimate Team video, guys. Today I'll be going over the most underrated, best value cards in Madden 21. Now, a lot of you guys have been asking for this because I've done most overrated, I've done most overpowered, but you guys were saying that you want something in between, right? Because the overpowered players are usually crazy expensive. They're crazy. And not everyone can afford them, and the budget beasts aren't always applicable to real competitive teams. That's more for like guys who are really balling on a budget. So you guys are like, what are the best values? Because I understand that entirely as a Madden player. Sometimes I'm looking, I'm like, okay, so this cornerback goes for 300, this one goes for 220, this one goes for 170. And quite honestly, the 220 is the same as the 300k, and the 170 is not too far behind. So it's like, should I take the best value of a guy that's similar in price? Which I do a lot of the times, where I see a guy who's the same exact card, same exact thing, just a lower price because of his name and or his team. You're like, you know, he's not, you know what I'm saying? You guys get the point there. Like, I can't think of an example right now, but maybe Mark Clayton, right? Mark Clayton, Dolphins, newer legend, Tyreek Hill's 270K. Mark Clayton's like one overall, one speed less when you have him fully powered up. And you're sitting there like, huh, why does Tyreek Hill power up and basically combine go for over 500,000 coins when Mark Clayton only go for like 250? Kind of a good example there. But guys, it's about it for that. Let's get into the video. And as you guys do know, if you want a chance to be shouted out on the Poodle Squad, all you gotta do is go down below, turn that noti bell, hit that like button, turn notifications as well, and make sure to comment down below Poodle Squad. Once you do all those things, you're entered to be shouted out. Now for today's Poodle Squad shout out, guys, as per usual, we have someone new here, Kalupi. Shout out to you, man, for being part of the Poodle Squad. Thank you so much for showing support each and every day. I appreciate you, man. And again, for anyone who wants to do it, join same exact way. Now guys, for these cards, before I get into the list, remember, if you guys do want a chance to pick up some of these cards and get some coins for these cards, they are great values, but if you don't have coins, remember to head up to MuttReserve.com. Coins and trading are currently highly discounted. Make sure you take advantage and use code Poodle for an additional 15% off. First card on the list, guys, Mark Clayton. Mark Clayton is a phenomenal receiver, is why he's on here. He's only, let's see what his price is. It's freezing, of course. I believe he's usually like in the 70K range. 60k range, depending on what time of the day you're looking at him. It is in the 80k range now. Of course, if you can snipe him out or do the set, you can probably get it for cheaper now. Beauty about Mark Clayton, he is a team diamond, so he is able to go ahead and actually get powered up all the way up to about a 90, I believe. So you can get his speed to a 90. His deep route running can hit threshold with go deep as well, and you're able to put some good abilities on him. So he's kind of like, he's pretty much a more budgety option of Tyreek Hill that probably is honestly better, quite honestly, just because he's going to be a better catcher overall. He's going to be a better overall card just with like minus one speed and slightly less deep route running, unless with go deep he ends up matching him, which again, Tyreek Hill with go deep probably goes to be even more. But Mark Clayton's an awesome budget value, guys, or good value for the price, considering it's not a budget card per se, you know, because 80k and of course powering up a card is never going to be considered a budget card. It's going to cost some money, but definitely great value in comparison. Then we got over here at left side linebacker for my next best most underrated player in Madden, Elvis Dumervil / Khalil Mack. Now, Elvis Dumervil is more of the short-term play, but Khalil Mack, the reason why he's on this list, because he's still pretty cheap. 145 is not bad for the price, not bad at all, considering getting Khalil Mack. And he just got a plus one on his power-up. So if you do power him up as well, he can get up to, I believe, an 89 overall now because the plus one. His power move will be threshold. His speed will be above an 80. His play work will be close to 90. And his block shed will be close to 90 as well. He'll get close to like an 88 block shed. So again, he's going to be super great. Going to get edge threat as well. And he's just going to be a really great value considering he'll be a top pass rusher in the game at a relatively cheaper cost for Khalil Mack. Like Khalil Mack's typically like Aaron Donald level in Madden, where he just gets crazy cards, glitchy cards. It's like he's always like in that LT, you know, well, it goes LT, then Aaron Donald, Khalil Mack, always in that certain like order. And Khalil Mack just hasn't gotten the same love this year in terms of pricing, so I feel like he's definitely a guy you want to be taking advantage of. You could really be doing some work with for a cheap price, plus the power up, of course. And I don't think his power up's even that crazy this year like it used to be in terms of pricing. Next on the list, we actually have a lineman, which I really like this lineman because he's very well-rounded, 170K, Brandon Linder, and just heavyweight linemen in general are just a great value this year. He's going to be a top run blocker and a top pass blocker simultaneously while being at a good price because he's capped by a training value, which is kind of what I like about the heavyweights and all that stuff. He will get chemmed up and powered up above 90 pass blocking, some of them high 80s and some of them, and then run blocking will be either above 90 or high 80 as well. So we're going to be between 89 and 91 for pretty much all the stats. So he's going to be a top tier interior force on the offensive line. And I feel like a lot of people just don't notice that, especially for his price of about, what is it, 170K? 174, and you can probably snipe him for about 165, 160, depending on the time of day you're looking. I think he's a great value. Now, this next guy, probably one of the best defensive cards in the game that you really just don't understand his value. Tyrann Mathieu at 245. The reason his value is so great is, first off, he's a superstar MVP card, so you don't have to power him up. You do not have to power him up. Now, you could, but you do not have to. Now, the thing with Tyrann Mathieu is that for 245, he gets pre-built with three abilities and an X Factor, and without being powered up, which the price of training right now, it could cost you over 200K just to get all those things in general. Plus, you get Tyrann Mathieu on top of that. Now, this card overall, if you get lockdown maxed on him, or not even, if you get lockdown like tier 3 or 4, he will get 90 play rec threshold, man threshold, and 90 zone coverage threshold, while also being an 87 speed. He could play nickel corner, he could play corner, outside corner, slot corner, you know, anywhere in the field. He could play deep safety. He could even be in the box as like one of those sub-package cornerbacks. Guys, Tyrann Mathieu is able to do pretty much anything on the field. He's so valuable because if you're in a, he can play any scheme. Like, you want to do man blitz right now, he can man up anyone because he has the man threshold. If you want to play a zone, he could play a zone coverage because he has a zone threshold. He's fast. He can catch. He's great with the ball in his hands once he gets a pick. He can do so much stuff, and it's honestly not a bad price. Like I said, you guys don't notice the price of cards. Like, oh, this card, but there's another safe that goes for 200K. Yeah, but then you got to power him up and chem him up to get all his abilities. And right now with the price of training, that can cost 400K. Tyrann Mathieu comes pre-built with everything off of the rip without having to do all that. Next on the list, guys, as we've gone up. Now, these are in no specific order. These are just cards that I think are great values. Now, today's veteran drop did bring about really good value players. Now, Jonathan Joseph's one of them for 190K. He's able to do so much. I wish he could be powered up, but chemmed up with lockdown. He's up 88 speed, 88 excel, 83 agility, 86 jumping. That's great. That's great for a card right now, in my personal opinion. Then he gets 90 play rec already, plus lockdown, he gets like a 93. He can get to a 90-91 man coverage, which is threshold, and a 90 zone coverage, and an 89 press. I wish his press can get one more higher, but it cannot. Unless you somehow get John Madden stuff, which I don't think this year can even do that. So that's the only thing that sucks right now, is that you're going to have to power this card up to get the press, which you cannot be powered up. But 90 play rec, over 90 man, over 90 zone. That is a three-headed monster, triple threshold cornerback that can play any spot in the field technically with those stats. And I think he's a great, great value. And because he's a veteran, he is going to get a cheaper price than cards that can usually do that, because he's capped by the price of training, which is always good in terms of that when you want a veteran card. Now, we usually don't want veteran cards, but this year they're good. Now, Akeem Hicks, 160K right there. Another great value. This might sell on me because I clicked on one so cheap. He's a great value. 60 speed, 77 excel, 91 strength. 91 strength is insane. 80 tackle is great. 93 play rec is insane right now. 90 block shot, 88 power move. And he can be powered up. Powered up and chemmed up, guys. He will get above 90 power move, which makes him a top tier pass rusher. Well above 90 block shot, which makes him a top tier run stuffer. Well above 90 play rec, which makes him a top tier play recognition guy. Great strength, which makes him super, he's super strong. And great tackle. Akeem Hicks overall is a great, great left end. And you really just can't discount the fact that you can get him for prices below 180 right now, like for that price. And of course, he could go down more or less, probably less depending on the price of training and how much he changes over the week. As training goes down, so will these cards. And the final guy on the list, kind of in the Jonathan Joseph territory. I actually think Joseph might be a little bit better, but nonetheless, they're similar. Stephon Gilmore, 85 speed. Now remember, he can be powered up, and then he does have a power up expansion plus one. So he can get to an 87 speed. He will also get the play rep threshold, the man threshold, the zone threshold, and the press threshold, which makes him better than Joseph coverage-wise. Just one speed slower, so it really just depends on what you like there. But you get 89 excel. You'll end up getting, just off power alone, probably a 90 play rec, a 90 man, an 88 zone, 89 press. Plus lockdown, you're going to get like a 92 play rec, 92 man, 90 zone, 91 zone, and then a 91 press as well. He's going to be a top-tier coverage guy at an 87 speed. Wish he was a bit faster, but he's still super, super great. Guys, all these cards in this list are great values. They're versatile. They can do a lot for their price. And of course, most of them can be powered up. Besides, I believe only one in this list cannot be powered up, which is great as well for your long-term outlooks. Now, the list goes as follows again. Mark Clayton, Khalil Mack, Brandon Linder, Tyrann Mathieu, Jonathan Joseph, Akeem Hicks, and Gilmore. Now, no specific order. These are my most underrated cards, guys. These are the cards you can rock with now, rock within a month, probably get some more cards throughout the year. Almost all of them probably get more cards. Besides, maybe Joseph and Hicks might have some struggle getting more cards. For the most part, because of just, you know, veteran cards. There's a reason why they put them there. They don't really give them upgrades in other places. But Gilmore for sure will get more, as well as Tyrann Mathieu, Khalil Mack. Mark Clayton was a big hit, so I think he might even get another upgrade at some point. But overall, these cards are just super fun. Thank you guys for watching. If you want a chance to be shouted out in today's next video's Poodle Squad, go down below, turn on that noti bell next to the sub button, like the video, subscribe to the channel, guys. Comment down below Poodle Squad as always. And of course, if you need coins for any of these, you know, these underrated best value cards, make sure you go to muttreserve.com, take advantage of the discounted coins and training, and use code Poodle for an additional 50% off. Thank you guys so much for watching. I'm out. See you in the next video. Peace.